Motorcycle Museum, and proud to be representing this absolutely gorgeous 74XLH1000 Sportster that we just did a full frame-up restoration on. Took us 2 months to do it, over 80 hours labor clocked on the bike, not including my time, and I put a lot of time into it. But the service techs, I'll show you all the tickets when we bring it inside. I believe this is a high watermark of Sportsters we've done as far as the fit, finish, the way it looks. It came out stunning. Just a fantastic color combination and a lot of fun to ride. We set this up to ride with XR1200 Sportster bars, long travel, nitrogen charged suspension, rebuilt set of forks, brand new Avon, top of the line Avon tires. It's got a Mikuni carb on it, straight pipes, drag specialty straight pipes, just a fantastic machine, mid controls. I just took it for a little test ride and everybody was mad at me when they got back. They're like, where'd you go? Well, I couldn't stop. I was having fun. It's a lot, and that's what it's all about. Let me give you a quick demo, because I'm sure the pictures and the video will tell the story, but I got a demo of this thing for you. It's awesome. It's a kickstart. Last year, they only made a very limited number of these. This is last year. They made them kickstart only. Very rare piece. Fires right up.
It does. It's surprisingly easy to kickstart. You know, most of these things that
yeah, it's super easy only, to kickstart.
You get kind of...
bike, a lot of fun to ride. This is hands down the best handling, best riding, best seating position of any Ironhead Sports I've ever been on, and I own a 77 Cafe Racer, so that's saying a lot. It's a lot of fun to ride. Turns heads everywhere you go. It's definitely a showstopper for sure. An investment quality classic Ironhead Sportster, best looking Harley engine ever made, and just sings a great song through that Mikuni carb and the straight pipes for sure. So I hope it goes to a good home. Hope somebody really appreciates how much time and effort it takes to build a project like this. We've got well over 50 hours into it. And like I said, it doesn't count my time. Just to give you a heads up, the paint job alone on this, I went back and forth to the paint shop 5 times, and it's a hour round trip. So I got 5 hours drive time, not to mention a couple hours in the paint shop, just picking out the paint scheme, the graphics. We tried multiple different graphics, multiple different paint schemes. I'm 52 years old, I've been doing this since I was 15, and I got an eye for it, and this bike is just off the hook, gorgeous, painted by Kevin Patterson. It's a full frame off, frame up restoration was done on this bike. My technician Mitch, excuse me, I misquoted, I have all the time cards, my technician Mitch has 73 hours into this bike, going through it front to top, front to back, top to bottom. The detail shop spent 12 hours detailing it, and we outsourced the painting. I don't know how much time he had into the paint, but well over 100 hours, including the paint job. We've got 73 hours of service tickets, I'll show you, and 12 hours of detail tickets. So a lot of time and effort, 2 months in total, and look at it, it's gorgeous. Let's bring it inside, and I'll give you a full rundown of exactly what was done to it. Okay, starting it.
to ride. So let me start at the front of the bike, give you a full rundown of everything that was done. I guess I'll go over the paperwork also. These are the service tickets over the course of 8 weeks. Every time they work on the bike, they punch in and punch out. There's a total of 73 hours of service labor and 12 hours in the detail shop, so 85 hours. Like I said, that doesn't include my drive time to the paint shop that we outsource the paint jobs to. We do paint jobs in-house here, but when we're doing something to the level that this bike was done, I outsource it to a paint shop, because on a scale of 1 to 10, our paint jobs are probably a 6 or 7, the in-house ones, and this guy can give me a solid 9 to 10. So Kevin Patterson's a world-class painter, been painting his whole life. All the products used on the paint job are top shelf. The graphics are all custom. Just a fantastic period correct restoration with a hint of modernization, a little bit of a resto mod done to the bike. The total cost of the parts is over $3,000 in parts, 85 hours of labor. The outsourcing of the paint job was $1,040 with the decals. We put $12,385 into the restoration, not including the original cost of the bike. That's over the course of a 2 month period, 85 hours labor. The black and gold one we just did only had 41 hours total. So this is literally twice the amount of work on this. And I guess I'll start at the front of the bike like I like to do and work my way to the back. I'll try not to miss a thing. Starting with the rims, the whole front end was taken off the bike. The rims were taken off, the bearings were taken out, brand new bearings were pressed in, and then the rims were painted black, including the spokes and the hubs. The original brake rotor was taken off along with the brake caliper, and we put this brand new GMI front caliper and the Russell around this side right here. Check out the brake system on this thing. It's one of the things our service team was pretty proud of, the way the brake system came out. It's a GMI brake with a custom mount and the drilled front disc brake. It's on point, brakes amazingly. These are the Avon AV53 trail rider tires. They have a nice aggressive tread to them. They're pretty badass looking. And with the fender, the original fender was sent out to our paint guy, painted, brand new hardware mounting it. So everything from here down was completely rebuilt. And everything from here up was completely redone. The steering head bearings are greased, reinstalled. The headlight is halogen style headlamp with original Harley Davidson aluminum front cover here, the original bar mounts, original triple trees. The frame is all original. It's a matching numbers bike. The bars are the Harley Davidson XR 1200 bars. These are the period correct built well white fish scale grips. They look awesome. They really match the paint job well. The master cylinder is a brand new master cylinder. All the brake lines are brand new. The mount for the master cylinder is new. The throttle tube is a new chrome throttle tube. New chrome lever, brake lever. Going back to the gas tank, the original gas tank was restored inside and out, and a brand new fuel pack was put on there with brand new fuel lines, so the fuel system's all restored. Brand new chrome bolt on the back, brand new chrome bolt on the front. Brand new LaPera Solo saddle, which is pretty fantastic. The original rear fender was completely redone, painted in the matching colors. The new license plate mount was mounted, and the original taillight was remounted on the bike. The rear wheel, and the brake system on the front is brand new. The brake system on the rear is brand new. Going from the other side, Kenny, and take a look at this right here. This is the actual brake housing. It's a brake drum. This is a brand new NOS brake drum that we purchased along, which included the brand new sprocket. Okay, so, and it has brand new brake pads. So the whole brake system on the rear of this is brand new. It has a brand new gold chain, which is really awesome looking, and it's a top of the line chain, a very expensive chain, best one we could possibly get. The rear wheel bearings were removed, pressed out, brand new ones pressed in, a brand new Avon AV54 matching. Look at the tread pattern on this thing. This thing is nasty. It's just a beautiful, it's almost like a dual sport tread. You can almost take this thing, bless you, God bless you, you can almost take this thing on the trails if you're not, I would ever do that, it's too beautiful. But the brand new Avon tire, tube, and rim strip. The original rear rim was painted to match. The painter that painted, Kevin Patterson, painted the gas tank and fenders, also painted the struts, so those are done to a high degree. These are brand new nitrogen-charged piggyback shocks from the UK. That's where they came from Australia. the original oil tank, which I think my daughter saw this and said, "Dad, it's my favorite thing on the bike. It's just a really cool looking square original oil tank." The original Kickstarter is on point and in perfect condition. The engine was rebuilt by the previous owner. These are the original Harley-Davidson cylinders, new pistons and rings. The top end was completely redone with all new gaskets. So when we got it, the engine was already done. It was in perfect condition. We did put a new chrome cover on this side, gap and clean the points, took the shifter off, cleaned that up, painted the shifter shaft. It's got highway pegs on there. We put a brand new set of drag specialties, drag pipes on here, wrapped them in the header tape. This is an original Screaming Eagle Harley-Davidson air cleaner mounted on a Mikuni carburetor. Check out this carburetor. This is what they put on the XR, XR 750 style Mikuni carb with the branch heads intake. It's the intake's by Branch, the carb's by Mikuni, the air cleaner's by Harley-Davidson. Brand new peckup, brand new fuel lines. So engine's on point, engine's in perfect condition, 150 PSI per cylinder. Come around this side right here. On this side over here, the entire primary was removed. A brand new Barnett performance clutch and plates, the metal and fiber plates and springs was installed, and a brand new chrome cover for the primary and a custom XLH 1000 logo on the side. It's got nice chrome, new chrome pegs on there to match the chrome highway pegs. Really like the highway pegs. I didn't use them at all during the demo, but if you're on a long country road, you put this baby in fourth gear and go. It handles awesome. Brand new battery, brand new wiring. We completely redid the wiring. The only original wiring is wiring that comes through the frame back tube. Everything on the back is brand new. Everything on the front is brand new. Everything has been rewired beautifully. Everything's inside of the headlight is brand new. The rear brakes are on point. You can lock up the rear brake, no problem. The swing arm is repainted. The frame was repainted. The whole bike was completely redone. We took the bike right down to the frame. The only thing left on the motorcycle was the cylinders and engine block. Everything else was taken off, redone and reinstalled over the course of an 8-week period. And like I said, there's 83 new grade 8 aircraft quality grade 8 shock bolts were mounted on there. Everything's been redone on it. Brand new axle adjusters. I forgot to point it out. Brand new axle adjusters. Check these out. Threads on them look new because they are brand new. Just a fantastic bike. I've got the previous registration, so you get the previous registration from Joe Cerrito. Joe and his brother are gearheads. Joe's in his late 70s. He had this bike for well over 30 years. They do GTO restorations. They have two GTO rag tops, solid $50,000 plus cars. They do frame offs, restorations there on cars. They had three of them in their shop when I went there. They did the engine. The engine's on point. It runs beautifully. Like I said, the engine, transmission, clutch, it's one of the best, if not the best, iron head I've ever ridden. It's got plenty of power. The exhaust note is on point. The carburation is perfect. The clutch is brand new. The transmission is tight. It kicks, the carburation is perfect, so it starts pretty much first kick every time. Very easy to kick over. Just a great bike. I don't know what else to tell you about it other than it's we're going to hate to see it go. And this is my favorite of any of the iron heads we've done. Check out our YouTube channel. We have over 900 videos of motorcycles we've restored at Kaplan Cycles. If you punch in Ironhead, you'll see some world-class Ironheads we've turned out. One of the Ironheads we did a cafe conversion similar to this, but black and gold. It went to a modern art museum in Canada. The guy that bought it paid $9,500 for it and sent it to Canada. We had a lot less work into that one than we had into this one. This one we maybe went too far. These are a labor of love when I do these. I don't know if we ever make any money off of them. I don't think so. Usually we lose money, but I like to have one of these cooking at all times. It just keeps me motivated and happy. I love doing custom resto mods like this, and it's good for the morale of the team to turn out a world-class piece like this. It's truly a masterpiece, and the whole team was involved working on this, picking out the color combo and everything else. So again, 83 hours, not including me obsessing about it for the entire 2 months. Who knows how much time I have in it, but my team had 83. So if you have any questions about the bike, give us a call, 860-454-7024. You're welcome to come take a look at it. The bike is on point, doesn't leak oil anywhere. It's just a beautiful iron head. Hopefully someone will get this and enjoy it for another 44 years old. It's an antique. It's a classic style iron head. Look at the side profile of this motor, Kenny. The most beautiful motor Harley Davidson ever made. So with that, I'm gonna roll her into back into the New England Motorcycle Museum. It's on display now in the New England Motorcycle Museum showroom. That's where it's gonna stay until it goes to its new home. So good luck bidding on the bike. God bless America, God bless Harley Davidson. God bless the new owner of this bike.